Hello students, today you will learn about division by one digit numbers from chapter 4, division. In math, division means splitting into equal parts or groups. And you probably use division a lot in your day-to-day life, even if you don't realize it. Let's imagine there are 12 cookies and 4 people want to share them. How many cookies should each person get if the cookies are shared equally? To get the answer, you must divide the cookies 4 ways. 12 divided by 4 is equal to 3. That means each person should get 3 cookies. Each of the 3 numbers in a division problem have a special name. The number being divided is called a dividend. The number that the dividend is divided by is called a divisor, and the result of the division is called a quotient. Now let's solve question number 1A from exercise 1. So in this question, we have to divide 7374 by 3. And then we have to check our answer using a certain rule. The number under the division bar, that is 7374, is the dividend, and the number outside the bar, that is 3, is the divisor. Now, in order to carry out division, we will first compare the leftmost digit of the dividend with the divisor. Here, the leftmost digit is 7, and 7 is greater than 3. So the next step is to do the division. That is, we need to first divide 7 by 3. That means we have to find how many times of 3 will be equal to or nearest to 7. Now if we look at the multiplication table of 3, we see that 1 time of 3 is 3, 2 times of 3 is 6, and 3 times of 3 is 9. Since 9 is more than 7, so 6 is closest to 7. So we consider 2 times of 3, which is equal to 6. And we write 2 as the quotient above 7. Now since 3 multiplied by 2 is 6, we write 6 below 7. And subtract 6 from 7. When we subtract 6 from 7, we get 1. Now we bring down the next digit, that is 3. Then we compare 13 and 3. Since 13 is greater than 3, we will divide 13 by 3. That means we have to find how many times of 3 is equal to or nearest to 13. We know that 4 times of 3 is 12 and 5 times of 3 is 15. And since 15 is greater than 13, 12 can be considered as nearest to 13. So we will consider 4 times of 3, which is equal to 12. So we will write 4 as the quotient above 3. And since 3 multiplied by 4 is equal to 12, we write 12 below 13 and subtract 12 from 13. When we subtract 12 from 13, we get 1. Now we bring down the next digit, that is 7. So the number becomes 17. Then we compare 17 and 3. Since 17 is greater than 3, so now we have to divide 17 by 3. And we know that 5 times of 3 is 15 and 6 times of 3 is 18. Since 18 is greater than 17, we can consider 15 as nearest to 17. So we can consider 5 times of 3, which is equal to 15. And we can write 5 as the quotient above 7. Now since 3 multiplied by 5 is equal to 15, we write 15 below 17 and subtract 15 from 17. When we subtract 15 from 17, we get 2. Now we will bring down the last digit, that is 4. Now the number becomes 24. Then we compare 24 and 3. 24 is greater than 3. So we will divide 24 by 3. So now we have to find how many times of 3 will be equal to or nearest to 24. We know that 8 times of 3 is equal to 24. So we will consider 8 times of 3. And we write 8 as the quotient above 4. Now since 3 multiplied by 8 is equal to 24, we will write 24 below this 24 and subtract them. When we subtract 24 from 24, we get 0. Now since we don't have any digit to bring down from the dividend, so our division is done. Here, the divisor is 3, the quotient is 2458 and the remainder is 0. Now, we can check the division using the following rule. Dividend equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. So we will put the value of divisor, quotient and remainder in this rule. Now, we will multiply 3 and 2458 and get the product as 7374. And now, we will add 7374 and 0. Any number added with 0 is the number itself. So we will get 7374, which is equal to the dividend. So the answer is correct. Now let's solve one question from practice 1. Question number 1. Divide and check the answer. Number A. 6040 divided by 5. Here we have to divide 6040 by 5. So 6040 is the dividend and 5 is the divisor. So to carry out the division, we put 6040 under the division bar and 5 outside. Now at first we compare the leftmost digit of the dividend with the divisor. Here the leftmost digit of the dividend is 6 and the divisor is 5. 6 is greater than 5, so the next step is to divide 6 by 5. That means we have to find how many times of 5 is equal to or nearest to 6. We know that 1 time of 5 is 5 and 2 times of 5 is 10. Since 10 is greater than 6, we can consider 5 as nearest to 6. So we will consider 1 time of 5 and we will write 1 as the quotient above 6. And since 5 multiplied by 1 is equal to 5, we will write 5 below 6 and subtract 5 from 6. When we subtract 5 from 6, we get 1. And now we will bring down the next digit of the dividend, that is 0. Now the number becomes 10. Then we will compare 10 and 5. 10 is greater than 5, so we will divide 10 by 5. Now we will find out how many times of 5 is equal to or nearest to 10. We know that 2 times of 5 is equal to 10. So we write 2 as the quotient above 0. And since 5 multiplied by 2 is equal to 10, we write 10 below this 10. And now we will subtract them. When we subtract 10 from 10, we get 0. And now we will bring down the next digit of the dividend, that is 4. We can even write this 4 without the 0. Now when we compare 4 and 5, we see that 4 is less than 5. That means we have to find how many times of 5 is equal to or nearest to 4. And we know that 0 times of 5 is equal to 0, which is less than 4. So we will put 0 as the quotient above 4. Now since 5 multiplied by 0 is equal to 0, so we will write 0 below 4. and we will subtract 0 from 4. 4 minus 0 is 4. So now we will bring down the last digit of the dividend, that is 0. And the number becomes 40. Then we compare 40 and 5. 40 is greater than 5, so we will divide 40 by 5. That means we need to find how many times of 5 is equal to or nearest to 40. We know that 8 times of 5 is equal to 40. So we write 8 as the quotient above 0. And since 5 multiplied by 8 is equal to 40, we write 40 below this 40. And now we subtract 40 from 40. 40 minus 40 is 0. Now since there are no digits to bring down from the dividend, the division is done. Here the divisor is 5, quotient is 1208, and the remainder is 0. Now we can check the division using the following rule. Dividend equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. So we put the values of divisor, quotient and remainder in this rule. Now we multiply 5 and 1208 and get 6040 as the product. And then we add 0 to 6040. When we add 0 to 6040, we get the same number, that is 6040, which is equal to the dividend. So the answer is correct. So students, that's all for today. I hope you have learned how to divide by one digit number. So see you in next class. Thank you.